Are you or any of your family member is taking a medicine called carbimazole for the treatment of a hyperthyroidism? Well, do you know that what is this medication? In what conditions we prescribe this medicine? How this medicine works? What should be the ideal dosage and what are the side effects? Can this medicine be taken during pregnancy? And certain life-threatening complications which can also happen if you don't pay attention. If you don't know all of these, then stay tuned with me because we are going to discuss that in our today's topic. Namaste, my name is Dr. Tanvi Mayur Patel. I am an endocrinologist, hormone specialist doctor from Mumbai, India. Now before I begin this video, a very important information. If you want to watch this video in Hindi language, then on the I button and in the description box, there is a link. If you click on that link, this video will be played in Hindi language for you. अगर आप इस वीडियो को हिंदी भाषा में देखना चाहते हैं तो ऊपर आई बटन पे और नीचे डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में एक लिंक है। अगर आप उस लिंक पे क्लिक करेंगे तो इस वीडियो को आप हिंदी भाषा में पाएंगे। Now, carbimazole is a medicine which is used for the treatment of a hyperthyroidism. Well, it is one of the most commonly used treatment for hyperthyroidism. See, hyperthyroidism can be managed by the many different ways. And one such and the most common method of the treatment is the anti-thyroid medications in which we use a carbimazole medication. Alright. Besides that, we have another method of treatment called as a radioactive iodine therapy. By the way, I have made a special video on a radioactive iodine. So in case if your doctor has advised you this method, then you can watch that video so you will have a very detailed knowledge about it. Now, as I told you, carbimazole is one of the most commonly prescribed medication. Many a time this medicine can be prescribed alone or sometimes we also prescribe this medicine along with the other method of treatment like radioactive iodine therapy. Sometimes you also use it in replacement or along with the thyroid surgeries or the operations. Sometimes we use this medication along with a special class of a medicine called as a beta blockers. Alright, so if your doctor has advised you this medicine, please talk to your doctor that what is the right indication for you. Now see, carbimazole is a most commonly used a chemical or a generic name of this medicine. In many other countries, this medicine is also known by plenty many other words like carbinazole, then carbimazolo, carbimazolum or a thyromazole and a carbethoxymethimazole. These are the certain other names used. But carbimazole is a most commonly used chemical name worldwide. Alright. Now, this medication is a prescription-based medicine. It is not a over-the-counter medicine. Understand, carbimazole is a hormonal pill. It is not any ordinary cough, cold or fever medication which you can take unless and until you are not advised to. Alright, this medicine is prescribed by your thyroid treating doctor or we call it as an endocrinologist doctors. By the way, do you know that carbimazole is such an important medication that it belongs to an essential drug list of a WHO, that is a World Health Organization? It is that important medication. Now, these medicines are usually available in a different doses like 5 mg, 10 mg and 20 mg. Alright, what is the right dosage for you? It depends on plenty many parameters like your age, what is your gender, whether you are male or a female, what is your body weight, whether do you have other health problems or not. Plenty many important points has to be kept in mind before deciding an individual dosage for you. Unlike all the medication which comes in a packaging of 10 or 15 medicines, carbimazole usually comes in a bottle packaging of nearly 100 to 120 medications. Now, these medicines are available by plenty many different brand names. The most common brand name are like neomarcazole, then antithyrox, then thyrodip, thyrocab. These are just a few brands. Alright, whichever brand is available locally to you, and easily available, you can use that brand, but make sure that the generic or a chemical composition has to be same. That is a carbimazole. Alright, this medicine usually comes in a packaging of 100 to 120 medicines. Now, why like that? See, usually this medicine is given at least for a period of 3 months before you start seeing any result. And that's the reason why this medicine comes in this packaging. Now, the pricing of the medication also varies based on what is the dose of the medicine, which brand you are using, and what is the quantity of the medication. Based on that, the pricing varies from different region to region and country to country. Now, most of the time, this medicine which is prescribed in India, the most used brand is a neomarcazole. Now, these medications are usually a round or a circular in shape. These medicines are not usually coated medicine and they are usually pink in color. Now, one side of the medicine, it is written the dosage 5, 10 or 20, whatever is the dose. And the other side of the medicine usually has a score line or a horizontal line. Now, what is the use of this score line? This score line is used for two reasons. First, if for any reason you are not able to absorb the tablet or you are not able to gulp the tablet whole, then in that case, you can break it into two and you can take it. Second use of the score line is that many a times if you want to titrate the dose to 2.5 milligram, in that kind of a situation, you can cut the 5 milligram tablet into two and you can get two equal halves. So that way also you can use this score line tablet use. All right. So these are the certain points to be kept in mind. Now let's talk about why is this medication prescribed or what are the indications. See, this medicine works on a thyroid gland and it reduces the thyroid gland activity. So in any situation where we want to reduce your thyroid gland activity, we are going to use this drug. We are going to use this medicine in any situation where we want to stop your thyroid action from performing to a hyper. So if you have a hyperthyroidism, this medicine is prescribed. See, hyperthyroidism is a condition in which your thyroid gland is working more than the requirement. There are plenty many reasons why hyperthyroidism can happen. One such reason is a Graves' disease. Graves' disease is one of the very common reasons for hyperthyroidism. This Graves' disease is also considered as an autoimmune health problem. Now, what is autoimmune health problem? When your body immune system manufactures or produces antibodies, and when these antibodies attack your own body cells, we call it as an autoimmune disease. Graves' disease belongs to an autoimmune class of a problem. So if you have a Graves' disease, your doctor might prescribe you this medicine. Another reason for hyperthyroidism is the thyroid nodule. Now, thyroid nodules are nothing but a small swelling of your thyroid gland, and this swelling is manufacturing a lot of thyroid hormone. So when you have a such hot thyroid nodule, we also use this medication. Along with that, there is another condition called as a thyrotoxicosis, wherein your thyroid hormone is making a lot of hormones, and because of that your body has a lot of symptoms. So we want to suppress that. Again, we use this medicine. Many times we use carbimazole medication for your body to prepare for other methods like a radioactive iodine therapy. So when you plan to undergo RAI therapy, few weeks or few days prior to the therapy, we use this medication so that your thyroid becomes in a euthyroid state. Another reason when we use this medicine, if you plan to undergo thyroid surgery or operation, again prior to the operation, we want that your thyroid should be in a stable state, and again we use this medication. So these are the certain indications when we use this medicine. All right. So if your doctor has advised you this medication, you can ask your doctor that what is the indication pertaining to your individual case. Now let's see when this medicine is not prescribed or what are the contraindications. See, one of the most common contraindication is that if your body is not able to tolerate this medicine, or if you are having a lot of allergic reactions or your body has a lot of hypersensitivity, then this medicine may not be right for you. Second contraindication is that if for some or the other reason your liver is not functioning properly and you are having a liver diseases, again this medicine may not be suitable for you. Or if you have used this medicine in the past and after using the medication, if you developed a lot of liver related health issues, again this medication may not be right for you. Another contraindication is that if you have used this medicine and you have developed any kind of a serious side effects like a pancreatitis or inflammation of the pancreas, or if you have developed blood complications, then again this medicine may not be right for you. Many times many people have some blood related health problems, what we call it as a hematological diseases. If you have such problem, again this medicine may not be right for you. Now then there is a certain diseases which are relatively not very common, like if you have a glucose and galactose malabsorption. Now these are actually digestive health problems where your body is not able to absorb the carbohydrate called as a glucose and galactose. Or if you have an enzyme deficiency like total lactase enzyme deficiency, or if you have a galactose malabsorption health problems. So if you have such health conditions, again this medicine may not be right for you. So if you have any of such condition, then please do speak to your doctor before you start taking this medicine so that your doctor is aware and your doctor can take a right decision to prescribe you or not to prescribe you this medicine. Now let's understand how this medication works or what is the mechanism of action. Now see, before we understand the mechanism of action, we must understand how the normal thyroid gland functions. See, thyroid is a very important butterfly shaped gland located in our neck. This thyroid gland makes two important hormones called as a T3 and T4 hormones. Now, to make right amount of T3 and T4 hormone, you need three important raw materials. First raw material you need is a very important micronutrient called as iodine. Second important raw material you need is a very special kind of an amino acid called as tyrosine. So what happens? When you have a tyrosine, when it combines with the iodine, there's certain chemical reaction happens. To speed up this chemical reactions, you need a very important third raw material, and that's an enzyme called as thyroid peroxidase or TPO. When you have a right amount of TPO enzyme and iodine and tyrosine, the chemical reactions will become better and smooth, and you will get a good amount of T3 and T4 hormone. Alright? Now, when you take a carbimazole medication, now this medicine is taken by your mouth. Okay, it's an oral medication. So when you take this medicine, within 1 or 2 hours, this medication will get absorbed and will start its action. Now, by the way, carbimazole medicine is actually, it's a prodrug. Now, this carbimazole belongs to a class called as thionamide, and it is actually a prodrug. Now, what do we mean by a prodrug? Prodrug, in a very simple language for me to make you understand, we can call it as an inactive medication. So whenever any medicine is an inactive or a prodrug, the moment you take this medicine, the medicine undergoes into chemical change and it becomes an active medication. Alright? So actually a carbimazole is a prodrug. So when you take this medicine by your mouth into your body, this gets converted into its active form, and this active form is called as methimazole. Sometimes we also call it thiamazole. Both are one and the same. So once you have taken the medicine is converted into methimazole. Now what happens? This medicine works at two ways. First, this medicine will reduces the iodine content in your thyroid gland. And the second and the most important way of action is that it reduces the activity of an enzyme thyroid peroxidase. You remember I told you that a TPO enzyme is very important for the formation of the hormone. So if you don't have a right balance of the TPO hormone, the hormone production will not happen. And that's the reason why this medicine will stop or it will reduces the hormone production, and thus it reduces the activity of a thyroid gland. So indirectly we can say that this medicine stops the production or reduces the production of a thyroid hormone. Now, the whatever medicine which is not utilized is going to get thrown out of your body or excreted out of your body. Now, this excretion mostly happens in the urine. Nearly 90% of the excretion happens by urine method. And the remaining 10% of the excretion happens by the fecal method, or it passes via your feces. All right. So that is how this medication works, and that is mechanism of action. Now, many a times, many people have a question that once I start taking the medicine, how quickly or how soon I'm going to see the effects in my body. Now, this is a very common question asked by people in the clinic setting, and previous videos many people have asked this in the comment box also. So to understand that, please understand one thing, that our thyroid gland prepares the hormone in a lot of quantity at a one go, and all this excess of the hormone gets stored inside our thyroid gland. Now if we cut your thyroid gland and see it under microscope, or what we call it histologically, we see that the thyroid gland is made up of many cells, and these cells, which we call it is a thyroid follicle cell. Inside the thyroid follicle, lot of hormone is a stored hormone. So this thyroid hormone, nearly 99% of it gets connected or it gets attached to a protein called as a thyroid binding globulin, what we call it as a TBG. So this thyroid binding globulin hormone gets stored in the form of a thyroglobulin. This storage is enough and sufficient for us to survive for around 2 to 3 months. So even if, let's assume that today your thyroid gland is not working properly, you still will not have any symptoms for another 2 to 3 months, because your body has already storage of that much hormone. So similarly, when you start taking the medication, you are not going to see the results immediately. Why? Because the hormone is already prepared in advance. This carbimazole medicine can reduce the production of new hormone. It usually does not disturb the existing and a prepared hormone. Alright, so you might not find lot of improvement in your clinical symptoms, or you might not see good results in your blood test immediately after starting the medication. You will see results only after few weeks to few months. That's the reason why we always tell our patients that please have patience. You might find changes only after a few weeks to few months. Alright, now coming to the dosage part of the medication. See, dose of this medicine depends on plenty many reasons. It depends on what is your age, whether you are male or female, what is your body weight, whether do you have any other health problems, whether you have a liver problem, whether you got a heart problem. So it depends on plenty many parameters. So your doctor will be the right person to decide what is the ideal dose for you. Alright, now as I told you earlier, these medications are usually available in a 5 mg, 10 mg and 20 mg dosage, which are most commonly used drugs. Alright, so when we start any person with a new diagnosis, so first of all, if we find that you are having any body symptoms which suggest that of a thyroid imbalance, we always ask you to do a blood test. So when we do a blood test, we find out that you have a thyroid imbalance. And only once we confirm that it is your thyroid imbalance, we start this medicine. This medicine is a hormonal pill, so it is not advised otherwise. So once your doctor decides that you are in hyperthyroid state and you will get benefit of this medication, your doctor will start you with the medicine. So when we initially start you with the medicine, you are usually prescribed a very high dose. It ranges anywhere from 20 mg to 60 mg per day also. So usually in the beginning stage, when we give you such a heavy dose, we usually divide it into parts. So we usually make it into 2 or 3 doses. So you might be advised to take the medicine in a 3 different or 2 different timing. Right? So this is called as an initial dosing. So once we give you the initial dosing for few weeks to few months, till we bring your thyroid under absolute control range, and that we call it as a euthyroid state. For us to achieve this euthyroid state, it can take anywhere from few weeks to few months. Once you achieve a euthyroid state, then in that case you need a subsequent dosage. The subsequent dosage are usually less compared to the initial dose. So many a times we use a different ways of managing the subsequent dosage. Two most common used regimens are there. The first regimen is a maintenance regimen. In the maintenance regimen, your dose can vary anywhere from 5 mg up to 20 mg per day. So when you use a smaller dose, we can give you this medicine at only one time of the day. Now, once this medicine is prescribed to you, your doctor might ask you for repeated follow-ups, and during the follow-ups, your doctor might do your thyroid blood test, will also do a liver function test to check whether you are developing any liver side effects or not. So this maintenance regimen can vary anywhere from 6 months to it can all the way up to go to 18 to 24 months. Again, it depends on case to case. All right. The second subsequent therapy method we use is a block and replacement therapy. Now, what happens in block and replacement? Here, you are given the antithyroid medicine carbimazole to high dose, let's say 20 to 60 milligram per day. And along with that, we also introduce another medicine, which is called the levothyroxine, which we usually use for hypothyroidism. Now, the dosage of the levothyroxine can vary again between 50 to 150 microgram. Again, it is a case-to-case dependent. So this is called as a block and replacement. So one side we are treating you for hyperthyroidism, other way we are treating you for hypothyroidism. Many people find a lot of improvement and a lot of clinical beneficial effects when they take a block and replacement. So what is the regimen your doctor has selected for you might be the right regimen for you based on your medical case. All right. Now, this medication carbimazole has to be taken by mouth. It is not an injectable medicine. Many people have another question that is this medicine has to be taken early morning on an empty stomach? Answer is no. See, thyroid diseases are basically of two types. When we talk about the hypothyroidism, for which we use a medicine levothyroxine. Levothyroxine has to be used early morning on an empty stomach because that medicine mechanism of action is different. But that's not the case with the carbimazole. Carbimazole can be taken on an empty stomach. It can be taken any other time of the day. This medicine can be taken before food or it can be even taken after food. However, whatever way you are taking, you have to make sure that you take the medicine in that particular fashion only. Don't keep on changing every day because that will show an impact on your thyroid blood test and on your clinical symptoms. So, this is about a carbimazole medication, when it will show you the effect and what is the mechanism of action. Now we are going to discuss a very important point which is asked by plenty many people in the comment boxes, and this is the most common question of a concern to all the women who come to me during my clinical visit. That doctor, can this medicine be taken during pregnancy or not? Please highlight on that. So we are going to discuss in detail about it. See, this point in itself is a very sensitive point. So I will try to elaborate as much possible as I can. See, when you have a thyroid imbalance, and if you are a woman, and if you are a married or a sexually active woman, and if you are planning for a pregnancy, you must always discuss this with your thyroid treating doctor. That doctor, I am planning for pregnancy. So when your doctor has a clear knowledge of it, your doctor can advise you the right kind of a treatment for you. Many a times when a woman is planning for a pregnancy, in that kind of a situation, this medication may not be right for you. So you have to communicate with your doctor very well. Now, if you are taking a carbimazole medicine and if you are planning for a pregnancy, then in that case your doctor might change your medication. That is the reason why we always tell a patient that if you are taking this medicine, make sure that you take a very good contraceptive care so that you don't accidentally get pregnant and conceive. When you plan and conceive, we have a sufficient time to change your method of the treatment. Now, what if you are pregnant? See, during the pregnancy, this medication is usually considered as a safe medicine. Now, the pregnancy, which is of a 9-month duration, is usually divided into 3 trimesters. First trimester, which is first 12 weeks, then the second trimester, and the third and the last trimester. So during the first trimester, during the first 12 weeks, we usually don't prescribe carbimazole medicine, and instead of that, we use another medicine called as a propylthiouracil or a PTU. As per the scientific data, during the second and the third trimester, carbimazole medication can be very safely prescribed, and this is also recommendations by many of the endocrinological societies. So during second and third trimester, carbimazole medicine is usually considered safe. Now, complications to a mother and to a newborn child can happen more if your thyroid is not in a control. See, most important during the pregnancy is that your thyroid has to be in a control. If your thyroid is not controlled, then you tend to have a more complications both to mother as well as to the child. So all the doctors, the prime objective pertaining to the pregnancy patients is to control the thyroid imbalance as much as possible. Now, when we are talking about the controlling the thyroid imbalance, we usually try to maintain a euthyroid or a right range of thyroid with the minimum medication as possible. The smaller the dose, smaller the side effects, and smaller the complication possibility to the mother and to a child. Alright, so the most important thing is the controlling the hyperthyroidism. Many a times patients hyperthyroid is not controlled and they develop a complication and then they blame it to the medicine. Sometimes it can be true, sometimes it cannot be true, because controlling the thyroid is the object. Now, so this medication, the carbimazole, is usually considered as a safe and effective medicine. Especially when you're planning for the pregnancy, before pregnancy and in the early pregnancy, we try to use as small dose as possible so that your thyroid remains in a euthyroid state. So the smaller dosage is usually preferred. Now, most of the patients tolerate this medicine well and do not develop any complications. However, there are certain complications which can happen to unborn child, and that complication should not be even neglected and should never be discussed. It's not like that. So what are the possible complications which can happen to the unborn child? Now, these are usually congenital malformations or the birth defects which happens from the birth. Now, in that, the very first common complication which can happen is called as a co-anal atresia. Now, what is this co-anal atresia? See, our nose has a passage called as a nasal passage. Now, if for certain reason, due to any kind of a soft tissues or due to by a bone, if this nasal passage gets blocked, this condition is called as a co-anal atresia, which can happen to a child whose mother has taken a carbimazole medicine. Second complication can happen is a condition called as a aplasia cutis. Now, aplasia cutis is a problem which happens to the skin of your scalp area. So, during this condition, the skin is absent, and that condition is aplasia cutis. Besides that, there are many other complications which can happen to the kidneys, to your heart problem also. Another condition called as a exomphalos. Now, what is this exomphalos? Here, the unborn child will his abdominal wall will be very, very thin or a fragile. Sometimes it can be even absent. So it is our abdominal wall which protects all the internal organs and keeps them inside. So in exomphalos, this abdominal wall is not correct, and due to that all the internal organs might come out in one pouch. So this condition can also happen to an unborn child, and this is a congenital malformations. So these are the certain complications which can happen to an unborn child. So as I told you earlier, that's the reason why during the first trimester we don't use carbimazole, we use another medication. But during second and third trimester, carbimazole is considered as a very safe medication. Along with that, the smaller the dose, less possibility of you having a problem. Another, uncontrolled hyperthyroid can have a more chances of a complication. So all these points also has to be kept in mind. Many times we use a block and replacement therapy. Usually this kind of a therapy is not used during the pregnancy. So when we talk about the women with the planning for the pregnancy and a pregnant woman, we take utmost precaution so that we don't come up with such kind of issues. Right. Another important special condition is a breastfeeding or a lactating mothers. Can women of this type take medication? So usually this medicine is excreted and secreted in a breast milk. So you can talk to your doctor and your doctor will advise you based on your case. Another important point is the elderly population or the people whose age group is above 65 years of age. Is this medicine suitable for them? Answer is yes. Okay, they can safely take this medication. However, many a time the dosage requirement in adult population and elderly population is little different. So your doctor might change your medication dose. Usually elderly population people, they tend to have a more common side effects of the carbimazole medicine. So we usually start with a small dose and then we up titrate, but this medicine is kind of a safe medicine. Another age group is a 3 year to 17 years of age group. This pediatric population, again, they are considered safe to take the carbimazole medicine. But again, the dosage requirement is very, very less. It can vary anywhere between 5 to 15 milligram per day. Then the population is a neonatal population or an infant population wherein the age group is less than 2 years of age. Now, during this age group, this medicine is usually not prescribed and we usually don't give this medicine. However, it depends on your case. So your pediatrician doctor will be the right one to advise you about it. Now let's talk about a very special condition called as a liver involvement. See, usually when this medicine is prescribed to you for the very first time, your doctor will do your liver function test to ensure that your liver is functioning properly. If your liver is functioning properly, you will be advised this medication. Or if your liver is not functioning properly, this medicine may not be right for you. At the same time, if you have any existing liver health problem or liver disease, then you have to talk to your doctor and inform your doctor so that your doctor can take a right decision. Many times when we prescribe you this medicine and after that prescription, when we do a liver function test, and if a liver function test becomes bad, your doctor might even again change your medicine. Usually this medicine is very safe. However, when you have a liver imbalance, the half-life of this medicine can also change. In a normal situation, when your liver is performing better, your carbimazole half-life is anywhere between 5 to 5.5 hours. But if your liver is not functioning properly, this half-life can even increase. Alright? So many a times when you start taking this medicine, and after taking the medicine, if suddenly you develop any kind of a side effects, then in that case you need to be alerted. Now these side effects are usually suddenly you develop a pain in your abdomen, or suddenly you find that your hunger or appetite has reduced. You find there's a lot of itching all over your body, what we call it as a pruritus. Or you might find that your body is turning yellow, what we call it as a jaundice kind of a symptoms. If any of symptoms such happens, you need to be immediately alarmed and you have to inform your doctor. Your doctor might do your thyroid blood test and along with that your liver function test. Your doctor might even advise you to do a sonography. And if you find that there is any kind of a liver involvement, your doctor might stop your medication. As it is found that the earlier if you stop the medicine, the damage to the liver is less. And if you have developed such problem in the past, then you have to inform your doctor about it so that your doctor can even change the method of a prescription to you. Alright, so this point also has to be kept in mind. Now let's understand what are the side effects of carbimazole. See, carbimazole is usually very well tolerated medication. It is a very commonly prescribed medication. The side effects are usually very mild and very well tolerated. Sometimes the side effects can be very small if the dosage is small. And sometimes the side effects can be dose dependent also. Now, what are the possible common side effects? I'm going to discuss that. Now, so most common side effects are the which happens in your digestive system. So many people develop vomiting sensations. Sometimes they can have a nausea. Sometimes they can have even vomiting. Sometimes some people also have a loose motions, what we call it as a diarrhea. Many a times after starting the medicine, many people find that they have changed the taste, or the loss of taste can also happen. People have also found that their hair becomes very thin. Sometimes after this medication, they might find that the skin has developing a rashes or an allergic reaction. Usually these are dose dependent. Your doctor might advise you any allergy medication and this should be fine. Sometimes after starting the medicine, many people might develop a headache or they might develop a dizziness. So within few days to few weeks, this side effects usually settle, and this usually does not ask a doctor to stop the medicine as it is very well tolerated. But sometimes there can be a serious complications. Now these serious complications are usually not very common, okay? And however, since you are taking the medicine, you should be always be informed about it. So what are the serious complications? One complication is the involvement of your liver, which I have just now discussed with you in detail. So if you suddenly find that there is a pain in your abdomen, if you develop any loss of a taste, or if you found that you are not able to eat food, your appetite has gone down, if you develop any kind of allergic reaction or rashes all over your body or a yellowness of your body, all this can be an indication of a liver involvement, and that can be a serious condition. Second serious condition which can happen, that's again that of your digestive system, and that we call it as an acute pancreatitis. Now see, pancreas is a small organ which is situated in our abdomen region. Now this pancreas, if it undergoes into sudden inflammation, we call it as an acute pancreatitis. So if you have an acute pancreatitis, again you might develop lot of nausea, lot of vomiting, abdominal unbearable pain. If that happens to you, again your doctor might not only do a liver test but also might do a pancreatic blood test. My doctor might even ask you to do a sonography to check whether there is a pancreas involvement or not. And if yes, you might even need to get hospitalized and get treated. So this is a second common, uncommon but serious complication can happen. Third serious complication which can happen is called as a granulocytosis. Now what is a granulocytosis? See, in our body we have a bones, and in this bones we have a bone marrow. Our bone marrow manufactures or prepares a special kind of a blood cells, like we call it as a RBC or WBC and a platelets. All the cells which are present in our blood, they are actually manufactured by the bone marrow. Many a times this carbimazole medicine causes the bone marrow activity slowdown or a suppression of their action. And because of that, you might experience that suddenly all the blood cells count has gone down. This condition, we call it as a granulocytosis. This can be very complicating and a life-threatening also. So we always tell a patient that in case suddenly you develop any kind of a fever, any kind of a sore throat or any kind of a cough, along with that, if you have any kind of a bleeding which happens from anywhere of your body, or suddenly you develop a lot of bruises, all this should be alarming to you, and in that kind of a situation you will immediately have to do a blood test called as a complete blood count or a CBC. When we do the CBC, we tend to know that what is the level of your blood cells, and if your blood count is down, then your doctor might completely stop this medication and you may not be even prescribed this medicine in the future. Now, these side effects, as I told you earlier, that they are not very common. They are rare. However, they are life-threatening, so you should be aware of that. What complications can happen in which individual? We cannot assure you that. Again, many a time the complication may not happen immediately after the medicine. Many times we have seen that the patient is taking the medicine for quite many months or the weeks, and then suddenly they develop such complication. So why it can happen, it is not easy for us to make you understand. But yes, please be aware of that and take a timely action accordingly. And in case if you have developed such complication and by chance you have changed your doctor, you must inform your doctor about it, that you have developed such problem in the past, so that your doctor is aware and can take a right action accordingly. Now let's see what is the action of a carbimazole medicine on another medicines. Now see, people when they have a hyperthyroidism, they can also have other health problems, and for those other health problems they also take other medications. What are those medications can have an interaction with the carbimazole? Let's understand. And then the very first medicine is called as a prednisolone. Now see, prednisolone is it's a steroid medicine. It is one of the very important medicine, by the way. So many a times people take prednisolone for a condition like an asthma or maybe a rheumatism or many other health problem. So if you take a prednisolone, then in that case, your doctor might change your dose of the prednisolone, because you might need to reduce the dosage a bit. Talk to your doctor about it, alright? Second medicine what we use is the anticoagulant medications. Now what are these medicines? See, first of all, understand what is coagulation. See, whenever we get any cut, it will bleed, right? And once it bleeds, it doesn't bleed continuously. After 5 to 7 minutes, the bleeding stops. This stoppage of the bleeding is called as a coagulation. For a coagulation to happen, you need a very good amount of a vitamin called as a vitamin K. Alright? Carbimazole medicine is a vitamin K antagonist, means its action is opposite that of the vitamin K. So in case if you are taking an anticoagulant medicine, like what are they? Like aspirin for that matter, clopidogrel for that matter, these are very commonly used anticoagulant drugs. So if you are taking such medication, the dosage of these anticoagulant again has to be changed, so you can talk to your doctor. Another medicine is a theophylline. Now theophylline is a very commonly prescribed medicine for the treatment of a bronchial asthma. So if you are taking a theophylline, again your dosage of the theophylline might be reduced. Another drug is a Digitalis. Digitalis is actually a medicine which is used for the treatment of a heart problem. So if you have taking Digitalis, again your doctor will change your medication dosage. Another medicine is called as a erythromycin. Now erythromycin is actually, it's an antimicrobial agent. Now when you take a erythromycin along with the carbimazole, again the dosage of the erythromycin has to be reduced. And the last drug is a beta blocker. Now beta blocker is a medicine which is used in plenty many conditions. Many times we use beta blocker along with the carbimazole medicine itself for the management of the symptoms of the hyperthyroidism. Beta blocker can also be used if you have a blood pressure problem or if you have a heart problem. So if taking beta blocker medicine, talk to your doctor might reduce the dosage of the medications accordingly. So these are the certain medications. So if you are taking along with the carbimazole, you must discuss with your doctor so that your doctor is aware of that. Alright. Another important point which I want to highlight is a condition called as an intrathoracic goiter, or we also call it a retrosternal goiter. It is a medical word. Let me explain that to you. What is it? Intra means inside. Alright. Thoracic. Thoracic is nothing but the region of our chest. In medical world, we call it as a thorax. All right. And the third word is goiter. Goiter is nothing but a condition wherein your thyroid gland enlarges. Most of the time, this goiter is usually external or outside, which can be seen. But sometimes this goiter doesn't happen external, but it rather happens internal. So it happens within your chest region. This we call it as an intrathoracic goiter. So we have seen that when a patient who has an intrathoracic goiter and when they take a carbimazole medicine, especially in the earlier stage, they tend to have a trachea obstruction. Now, what is a trachea? Trachea in a simple language is a windpipe. So when we breathe in and breathe out, the air from our nose goes to our windpipe or a trachea, and from that it goes to your lungs. So when you take the medication, you can have a stoppage of the airflow, what we call is a tracheal obstruction. So if you have an intrathoracic goiter, your doctor will keep this point also in mind and will advise you accordingly. Usually this intrathoracic goiter does not happen that commonly. It is a relatively uncommon condition. However, you need to keep this point in mind. Alright, so this is what we saw about carbimazole medication. What is this medicine? How do we use it? When do we use it? What are the dosage and what are the side effects? If after watching this video, if you have found some good useful information, please don't forget to click on a like button. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you get more and more health related information, especially hormones related information. And if you have any of your personal question, then please don't forget to write that in the comment box. I will try to read them as early as I can and reply them as soon as I can. And then there is a bell icon. If you click there, as and when my new video will be published, you will get an instant notification for the same. All right. Thank you for joining me till now, and I wish you all the best for your health, and we will meet again in our another video with some new good useful information. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.